We were just wondering over in the offices if you have ever lost any work because you forgot to hit save in the past hour or so. Did that make you cry? Did you miss a deadline because of it? Well, we got the answer for you. And best of all, it's free. So what we have for you today is we're going to show you your first look at Autosaviour by Astute Graphics. So when you first install Autosaviour, it's set to ask for autosave settings immediately when a new document or a document that Autosaviour hasn't seen before is open. So I'm just going to come over here to File, New to create a new document. And I'm just going to go ahead and accept whatever settings are in here. Click OK. And then right away, Autosaviour jumps into action. So right here, let's start at the top. So if I click over here, Enable Autosave Remind, I just go ahead and click on this. It's going to set every 10 minutes to remind me or autosave. Right now I have this button checked, so it's going to autosave every 10 minutes. And if I want to change this, I got these buttons here. I could add some time here, or I could actually reduce some of the time. I have this drop-down menu here where I could choose a specific amount of time, up to 120 minutes, or you could click and drag right here. And once you have this highlighted, you could enter in whatever value you want, but just keep in mind that it maxes out at 180 minutes. All right, down here at this section, let me bring this back to 10 actually. So I'm telling Autosaviour right now that every 10 minutes I want you to save, but I actually want you to wait 5 seconds after I make a change before you go ahead and save anything. So that's a great little feature when you're going ahead and working along, because don't forget that autosaving will pause Illustrator each time the document is being saved. Complex artwork or the presence of large embedded images may cause significant delays when your saving takes place. So keep that in mind when you're working with this. I actually like having this feature on so that I could continue to work, and then once I stop making my changes, Autosaviour will go ahead and save that for me. If I check this box right here, it'll create a little backup for me, and I even have the option of changing the suffix to whatever I want. That helps me out keeping everything organized, and I could find my stuff really quick that way. But what this is great for is, let's say Autosaviour jumps in after 10 minutes and 5 seconds, and it makes a save. And then I realize I actually want to go back to my previous version. Well, if I have this box checked right here, Autosaviour will go ahead and take care of that for me. So far, I've just been talking about how to actually save your documents for this particular document when you're working. But if I check this button right here, it's not going to do any saving for me. It's just going to remind me to go ahead and save something. So I'll see a little dialog box that says, hey, 10 minutes have already passed. You might want to go ahead and save your document. All right. Now, like I said before, this is for this particular document. And down right here in this section, this is going to deal with the default settings for Autosaviour. So at the moment, I have it set to ask for Autosaviour settings immediately. And that's why you saw it jump into action as soon as I created a brand new document. Now, if I would have created this off of a template that already had my Autosaviour settings applied to it, it might not jump out. It's going to actually use whatever settings I had in there last. So it'll actually retain your settings for your document. All right, so if I don't want it to jump out immediately, I could click this button here and it'll actually jump out after 10 minutes or however much I specify here. I'm gonna leave mine set to immediately because I just like having it there for me. I feel a lot safer with Autosaviour there. All right, I could also tell it to actually, before I go into that one, I'll show you this right here. You could actually specify things how we did above over here. So all this stuff should look familiar to you. You could have it set to auto save every 10 minutes. You could tell it to wait for 5 seconds after your previous change. And again, you have this option to create a backup with whatever suffix you'd like. You could also tell it to just remind you instead of creating an actual auto save. And then down here at the bottom, the one I was jumping to was don't auto save remind unless I manually enabled it. Now, this one is gonna have Autosaviour pretty much just sleeping in the background a little bit. If I click OK, and you want to manually go into your Autosaviour settings, all you have to do is come over here to File, find Autosaviour settings, dot, dot, dot. And when you click on that, it's going to bring you your Autosaviour settings back here. Now, the last thing I wanted to mention is that the functionality without a license key is identical to the activated product, except that the About screen is going to show up each time you lost Adobe Illust I mean, each time you launch Adobe Illustrator. And there you have it, folks. That's the demo we have prepared for you guys today to check out your first look at Autosaviour. Right now, we're going to be joined by Nicholas Vanderwall, the founder of Astute Graphics, and we're going to open it up to a little bit of Q&A.